Hello, welcome to this how-to video. My name is Andrea Schumann. I'm a support architect for SAP Cloud ALM. In this video, I will demonstrate how to set up integration and exception monitoring for SAP Field Service Management in SAP Cloud ALM. I will show you how to activate integration monitoring for the ERP connector and for the FSM connector, and how to create a client key in SAP Field Service Management. I will also demonstrate how to create an endpoint in SAP Cloud ALM, and how to activate the monitoring data collection. To activate the integration monitoring in SAP Field Service Management, log on to your main account page. The first step is to activate the integration monitoring data collection for the company and the connector you use. While it is rare that customers use both connectors, the activation for both connectors is shown in this video. Please pick the one that is relevant for you. To access the connector maintenance, you have to go to the company for which you want to activate the monitoring. You can access the company either via the Companies panel on the main account page or in the left navigation tree via the entry Companies. Select a company by clicking on the company name. Via the navigation tree on the company's main page, you can now access the connectors. Let's start with the ERP connector. Click on ERP connector. Switch to edit mode. Change the value for integration monitoring from false to true. Press the update button. Go back to the company's main page to activate the FSM connector. Click on FSM integrations. Click on FSM connector. Switch to edit mode. Check the box next to integration monitoring enabled. Click the update button to save your changes. The next step is to create a client key in SAP Field Service Management. This will provide the credentials you need to connect from SAP Cloud ALM to SAP Field Service Management via an endpoint. To create a client key, you need to go back to the main account page. You can get there by clicking on the account name on top of the navigation tree. On the account page, select the entry Clients in the navigation tree. In the Clients menu, click the Create button to create a new client. Make sure Client Authentication method is set to Client Secret. Under User Groups, find the company for which you want to collect the information. It should be the same one for which you activated the integration monitoring. Change the value from No Access to Default by selecting Default from the drop-down box. Click the Save button. Make sure to copy and store the client ID and the client secret displayed on the screen. Once you close the screen, there will be no way to access the client secret again. This concludes the setup steps in SAP Field Service Management. You also need to obtain the correct root URL and the token service URL for your endpoint in SAP Cloud ALM. You find this information in the SAP Cloud ALM for Operations Expert portal under Integration and Exception Monitoring Details, SAP Field Service Management, Setup Steps in SAP Cloud ALM. To find out which region you are in, check the URL you use to connect to your SAP Field Service Management account. Copy the root URL for your region and the provided token service URL to the file that contains your client ID and secret. Now we get to the setup in SAP Cloud ALM. Log on to your SAP Cloud ALM tenant. Make sure that you have the authorization, Integration Monitoring Integration Architect, to be able to perform the necessary setup steps. The first step is to create an endpoint to your SAP Field Service Management tenant in Landscape Management. You find the Landscape Management app in the group Administration. Open the Landscape Management app. Your SAP Field Service Management tenant should already be available in the Landscape Management, as it is automatically imported from the System Landscape Information Service at SAP. Click on the Name or the Details button for the cloud service. On the tab Endpoints, click the Add button to create a new endpoint. Enter an endpoint name and the description. Select Integration Monitoring as use case for this endpoint. The root URL is automatically copied from the cloud service information in the landscape management. You have to change this root URL to the matching API URL you saved earlier. Select OAuth to Client Credentials as authentication type. Enter the client ID and the client secret you saved earlier. Enter the token service URL from your file. Please be aware that currently, if you click the Check Connection button, you will get an error. You can ignore this message. The data collection works nonetheless. Save your endpoint. This concludes the activities in Landscape Management. The last step is to activate the data collection for integration and exception monitoring for the SAP Field Service Management service. You find the integration and exception monitoring application in the group SAP Cloud ALM for Operations. Open Integration and Exception Monitoring. The cloud service needs to be in scope for integration and exception monitoring to be able to perform the configuration. Open the scope selection. Make sure Display Service contains all. Add your SAP Field Service Management service to the selection. Click the Apply button. Now open the configuration panel using the rec wheel icon in the upper right corner. In the Services tray, you find your SAP Field Service Management service. Activate the data collection by sliding the lever from off to on. Activate the auto refresh for the application if it's not already active. You will see the collected messages after a few minutes. This concludes the standard setup for integration and exception monitoring. Thank you for watching this video. You now know how to set up integration and exception monitoring for SAP Field Service Management with SAP Cloud ALM. For further information regarding the technical setup, feel free to consult the SAP Cloud ALM for Operations Expert Portal, which is continuously updated with the latest news. A link to the Expert Portal is provided in the description of this video.